Okay, this is the first Randy versus Chuck fight. We have got two very good wrestlers doing two very different things here. Randy is fantastic at getting people to the ground with an MMA emphasis. So he was really the first wrestler that worked with wrestling combined with MMA. So he kind of had a system. Chuck, on the other hand, was really the first man to think about getting up every time he hit the ground. He just would not lie there. So we have two very proficient wrestlers, both excellent opposites, so it's a great fight. What we're going to see here is we're going to see Randy do one of the most basic takedowns that we need to know in MMA. I'm going to talk your way through it. I'm going to try and stick away from very wrestling orientated language because I've had a few complaints with people saying that they can't understand the technical stuff, so I'm going to try and make it less technical and make it more available to everybody, so in talky terms, whatever talky terms are. Right, so what's going to happen here is we're going to see our wonderful Mr. Chuck throw a kind of fakey hand. He's going to put it out in front of himself. He's masking a leg kick, so he's going to throw a fake and put a leg kick in. Randy is going to respond to the fake, and he's going to change level underneath that as a reactive shot, and he is going to move in. Now, I don't know if Randy knew that leg kick was coming. He might have done, he might not have done, but in a way it's very lucky that that leg kick comes in. I mean, wrestlers have to be careful with this technique here, because if this had been out here, Randy would have probably been asleep. So Randy didn't really know that this leg kick was coming, but it's been a gift from the MMA gods. So Randy moves in and he collects that knee. So he forms a hook with his hand, and the palm is on the inside of the knee, and he pulls it in towards him. He moves forward, so he shoots slightly off this back leg, and he gets his head onto the hip at the moment. He wants the shoulders to go onto the hip, and he's going to control the upper hip of Chuck Liddell. Now, with a blast double, normally what we'd want to do is we'd want this hand to go on the back of the knee. He would rip those knees under and push with his head, and he would end up in Chuck's guard, and it would probably still be an open mat. But I don't know if this is planned or not planned. The results are better from this takedown, so it might be planned. But Randy is going to put his hand in and control the hip. So if we move it a little bit forward, we see Randy control the hip. Already, if you see what Randy's doing, he is moving his head out to the hip, and he is driving his shoulder up from the hip into the solar plexus of Chuck. That means that Chuck can't sprawl, he can't lean forward, he can't do anything too much to get weight on top of Randy, just because of his body position. Randy is cutting this knee with the back of his hand, and he is going to now drive Chuck towards the cage. Now, Chuck does a good job of maintaining his balance at this point, because Randy pushes him here. Because this knee isn't cut, Chuck can keep the weight over the post of one leg, and once he gains his balance, he can be driven back to the cage. Now, I didn't notice this the first time I watched it, but we actually see Randy knock this leg as our wonderful Mr. Liddell is being taken back. So he does attempt a kind of, he doesn't get in for the reap, but he gets his knee on the side of the thigh and he knocks that slightly across and gets it lifted. The only thing that saves Chuck at this point, really, because he is falling now, is the cage. So Chuck has fallen. His legs are actually out in front of himself, which is not the best position in the world for Chuck. In response to this double leg, what Chuck really needed to do was to get his legs very wide apart, his hips facing Randy. His bum would have been on the cage, and Chuck should have been leant over so that he can absorb the bounce and force Randy down with his chest as the bounce happens. He's not been able to do that. Basically, he's just not been able to catch up with Randy's movement and also the knock that Randy gave this leg as he took him down. Now, this is brilliance what Randy's going to do. This is what I mean by an MMA wrestler. So what he's going to do is he's going to use the bounce off the cage to load our choke up. So the bounce off the cage allows Randy to lift Chuck up. Look, he's not really in the control zone at this point. I mean, the control zone's probably over here. What I mean by the control zone is that he would want to get a leg under Chuck's center of gravity. So Chuck's center of gravity is basically in his hips in this line here. So he would want to get a foot under his center of gravity, but he doesn't need to do that because what he's going to do is he's going to bounce him off the cage and he's just going to pick him up. Whoops. So he's going to bounce him off the cage and he's going to pick him up in the sky. This is delightful and beautiful. So he has choices here of what he's going to do. If his other hand was on the back of the knee, this hand's on the back of the knee, he could just pull both knees upwards, one on each side of his body, and slide Chuck's back down the cage and then have head over head control. We call it a wheelbarrow double leg because it's like the two handles of the wheelbarrow. And then we would see the pressure of Chuck's hips onto the hips of the guard of Chuck, and he would punch the poo out of him. Or we've got like a swinging double leg, if it makes more sense. It's a bit like a golf swing. This is what Randy's going to do. So he's bounced him off, he's got his hips in the sky, he's got control of the knee, he's got control of the hip. What he's going to do now is he's going to step this foot in towards the middle of the cage and away, and he's going to stand up and he's going to swing this knee up and around and this hip up and around. All right, but there's one little tiny detail to add to this as well as we go through this. So he stands, he whips that knee and he whips that hip, and also look what he does with his right leg. It's left leg. Yeah, his left leg hits Chuck's knee and it pushes it across. Absolutely gorgeous. Look at that. Just sweeps that thigh across. So not only is he pushing with his head into the chest, not only is he lifting this knee, not only is he swinging this hip, but he's also using his thigh against the leg to make this bit go up while that bit goes down. I sound patronizing now, don't I? I need to not be patronizing. So he's going to get Chuck to spin around this shoulder, which is in the center of his chest in his solar plexus. So we'll go through this again. He pulls it through, he kicks the knee, he lifts, he lifts, he lifts, he swings. His head and ear is on the chest. He gets him horizontal, and that's the point at which he's going to take him to the ground, okay? Really what we want with Randy now is we want him to be looking where he wants to put Chuck. Chuck is making some kind of reaction with the cage. It's not going to help him very much. He looks at the ground and he just takes him to the ground. He's now racing Chuck to the floor. This to me is one of the best bits of the whole takedown. I know it doesn't look anything, but for me it's beautiful. So this is one of my favorite bits to the whole takedown. He's blocking this leg on the way down from recovering guard. I mean, I don't know if he knows he's doing this, but when I teach this is what I do. I get people to drive them to the floor with that arm in place. And he's taking his hand from here to the underhook. So he's already established, he's actually in side control as he's taking Chuck to the floor. So as he takes him to the floor, he falls with him for the perfect takedown. And he's established his underhook, and he's going to turn his hip in. Chuck's so good, he already gets his half guard and takes him to the ground. Absolutely fantastic. All right, it's a very quick takedown. So it's in real terms, real speed, it's a very quick takedown, but there's an awful lot going on in there. As I say, Randy was the first real wrestler that put MMA and wrestling together using the cage. His dirty boxing was beautiful. I got the privilege of training with him and stuff a couple of times, and what I learned was he could really beat people up and there was nothing you could do about it. But apart from that, you really need to add these things to your game if you can, and good luck with it.